from Broad Awakening, the sequel to Underwater Vibes. And if you don't speak French, just pretend you do. Hélène, she's from Belgium, and Sylvie is her private swimming coach, and they're in the locker room, and Sylvie's from Greece. For once, Hélène felt so good she forgot where she was. Reaching her arms high into the air, she began dancing on the tips of her toes. Just as she was performing a double pirouette, she heard clapping. Her heels dropped with a thud. "You seem ready to roll," Sylvie quickly kissed her on the cheek. "I guess so," Hélène stammered, pulling away. But it was too late. Sylvie's soft skin and distinctive scent had already grabbed her senses. Her body remembered their passionate kisses at the beach, and she felt weak all of a sudden. Sylvie flashed Hélène a grin. "So I guess you made it home all right." She tugged the string around her waist. Hélène caught her breath as Sylvie removed her sweatpants, revealing her smooth, muscular thighs. Shedding her sweat jacket, Sylvie pulled her t-shirt over her head. Masses of black curls tumbled onto her broad shoulders. A few untamed strands settled between her breasts, propped up firmly by her swimsuit. Despite the locker room's damp chill, Hélène felt her cheeks boiling. Her gaze remained riveted to Sylvie's body. She cleared her throat. "That's a nice suit. Enfin, I just love yellow." "Me too," Sylvie grinned. "In case you haven't noticed, nearly everything I own is yellow. My car, my apartment, my cat. Even your nipples," thought Hélène, eyeing the direct pair in Sylvie's lycra suit. "Excuse me." Hélène raced toward the nearest bathroom stall. She plopped herself on the toilet seat. "Why do I always feel like such an idiot around her?" The answer came instantly. "Because I'm always acting like an idiot around her. Because I've never been exposed to such raw beauty, and certainly not on a daily basis, nor on a touching basis. I've never even looked at women before, consciously anyway." Hélène's heart pounded as images of Sylvie's body flashed before her. "Now I see what men are talking about," she realized, squeezing her clammy thighs together. Just then, a light knock, followed by Sylvie's sexy voice, penetrated the stall. Hélène froze. She looked up at the ceiling, wondering what to do next. "Alors, you okay in there?" asked Sylvie. "I'll be right out." Hélène tiptoed out of the stall, trying not to draw attention to herself. Sylvie, in a white bathrobe, stood next to the sink, patiently waiting. Hélène thrust her hands into the cold faucet water, hoping it would calm her nerves and other body parts. Sylvie's dark eyes were staring at her in the mirror. "Listen, I'm sorry about the beach. I'm not quite sure what happened." "Ne t'inquiète pas. Forget about it." Sylvie draped her arm over Hélène's shoulders. "It's freezing in here. Let's go work out before we catch frostbite." If she only knew, thought Hélène, wiping the sweat off her brow.